Colonel, your niece is going to be okay.
Thanks, Snake. I owe you one.
Now that Mantis is beaten, Meryl's brainwashing should wear off, right, Naomi?
Yes. But why did you go so far out of your way to save her? For Campbell's sake, or maybe it's because you like her?
I don't want to see any woman die right in front of me.
Oh, really? Since when did anybody's death bother you so much?
Naomi, it's true that Snake has killed a lot of people, but that doesn't mean he doesn't have a heart.
It's okay, Colonel. She's right.
So, you used the other... I wasn't able to read the future.
A strong man doesn't need to read the future. He makes his own.
Perhaps so. But I will read your future. To get to Metal Gear's underground maintenance base, you have to go through that hidden door. There's a hidden door behind the bookcase. The overland route. It's blocked by frozen glaciers. Go past the communication towers. And use the tower's walkway.
Why are you telling me this?
I can read people's minds. In my lifetime, I have read the pasts, presents, and futures of thousands upon thousands of men and women.
Oh, gross.
And each mind that I peered into was stuffed with the same single object of obsession. That selfish and atavistic desire to pass on one's seed. It was enough to make me sick. Every living thing on this planet exists to mindlessly pass on their DNA. We're designed that way. And that's why there is war. But you are different. You're the same as us. We have no past, no future. We live in the moment. That's our only purpose. Humans weren't designed to bring each other happiness. From the moment we're thrown into this world, we're fated to bring each other nothing but pain and misery. The first person whose mind I dove into was my father's. I saw nothing but disgust and hatred for me in his heart. Died in childbirth. And he despised me for it. I thought my father was going to kill me. That's when my future disappeared. I lost my past as well. When I came to, the village was engulfed in flames.
Are you saying that you burned your village down to bury your past?
I see that you have suffered the same trauma. We are truly the same, you and I. The world is a more interesting place with people like you in it. I never agreed with the boss's revolution. His dreams of world conquest do not interest me. I just wanted an excuse to kill as many people as I could.
You monster.
Let him talk. He doesn't have much time left.
I've seen through evil. You, Snake, you're just like the boss. No, you're worse. Compared to you, I'm not so bad. I read her mind as well.
Meryl's?
I saw you there. You have a large place in your heart.
A large place?
Yes. A large place. But I do not know if your futures lie together. I have a last request.
What is it?
My mask. Put it back on.
Okay.
Like this, other people's thoughts force their way into my mind. Before I die, I want to be by myself. I want to be left alone in my own world. I'll open the door for you. If you want to find your future, go through that door. This is the first time I've ever used my power to help someone. It's strange. It feels kind of nice.
And now he's dead.
Let's go, Meryl.
I'm sorry.
Meryl?
How could I let Mantis control my mind like that?
If you're gonna doubt yourself, I'll leave you here.
You're right.
Never doubt yourself. Just let it make you stronger. Learn something from it.
You're right. I'm sorry. I won't do it again. Snake, can I ask you something?
What?
About what Mantis said. I was just wondering.
What? What's the problem now?
Oh, no, nothing. So, tell me, Snake. What's your name? Your real name.
A name means nothing on the battlefield.
How old are you?
Old enough to know what death looks like.
Any family?
No, but I was raised by many people.
Is there anyone you like?
I've never been interested in anyone else's life.
So you are all alone. Just like Mantis said.
Other people just complicate my life. I don't like to get involved.
You're a sad, lonely man.
Come on. Let's go.
Ah.